Hi, I'm Dr. Jessica Osuna from Lawrence Livermore National Lab. I'm an atmospheric scientist there working at NAREC, or the National Atmospheric Release Advisory Center. At NAREC, we use computer models to predict the spread and the impact of contamination that might be released to the atmosphere, whether that release is accidental or intentional. While NAREC models chemical and biological material, we really focus on radiological and nuclear releases to the atmosphere. For example, from a nuclear power plant, a medical facility, or maybe even a nuclear weapon. As an example, NAREC played a key role in understanding the release of material from the Fukushima power plant in Japan in 2011 when that power plant experienced a meltdown. NAREC has staff on call 24/7 to provide accurate and timely information to government officials when something happens. This information is used to help officials make decisions about where they need to send first responders and resources and what needs to be done to keep people safe. Right now, a lot of my time is spent preparing for the launch of the Mars rover named Perseverance. Once Perseverance gets to work on the Red Planet, it will be powered by a nuclear battery. And that's why NAREC is an essential part of the launch support. In addition to the staff in the NAREC Control Center in Lawrence Livermore National Lab, myself and another scientist will head to Kennedy Space Center when the Mars rover is launched aboard an Atlas V rocket this summer.
And liftoff of the United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket.
Since I'm sheltering in place this week, my options are a little bit limited for showing you a demo, but I'm going to try to come up with something in my kitchen that can help you to visualize what it is that the NAREC computational models are calculating to help us understand the dispersion or the transport of contamination in the atmosphere. So we have now moved into my kitchen, not my dining room, because we're going to be working with water. I have a density tank here. It's just filled with room temperature water, and I picked up some help along the way also. I have my son who's going to help out, and my daughter is behind the camera. So what we're going to do here is we're going to use this density tank to demonstrate what the computer models of NAREC are actually calculating. And we can do that because the atmosphere behaves like a fluid. So we're going to use water to visualize that. The first thing, we have hot water heating up right now. And we're going to put a little bit of food coloring in here. And we also have cold water that we've colored blue. For now, to start, we have a divider in the density tank that's going to keep the different portions separate. So I'm going to pour the hot water in here. Then I'm going to use this to transfer it to this little vial. And this little vial is going to act like a release of contaminant to the atmosphere. So we have our contaminant in our vial. I'm going to put a lid on it. And I'm going to put it into our density tank with room temperature water. And if I'm really careful, I can keep it standing up and take out the lid. Come on, there we go. And you can see that the hot water rises. And you can imagine if this was a contaminant that was warmer or less dense than the atmosphere around it, it would also rise because hot air or hot water is less dense. Now let's see what happens when we pour cold water. Can you show me your cold water? We have cold water that's blue. He's going to pour that right in the density tank. And you can see that that cold water tends to sink to the bottom. So now what happens if we let these two air masses or masses of fluid mix? Go ahead. He's going to slowly release the divider and let the whole density tank mix. So now we see that as the contaminant continues to be released from our vial, you can see the red continues to go to the top, and as it pushes across the density tank, this blue, which was the cold water, is coming down, coming across the whole bottom. And you can see here, if you look closely, you can see where the red contaminant is rising. It's actually pulling some of that blue air from the surface, or blue fluid from the surface, up to the top. And that's just how you can get mixing of different parts of the atmosphere. That can occur either due to the drag of that flow going upwards, or it can be due to the heat of our vial heating up the air around the vial and then that air rising. So this gives you a good idea of all of the dynamics that the computer models calculate when we are calculating where a contaminant in the atmosphere might go, how much of it is at the surface, and how much of it is up high. And of course, people live at the surface, and so we want to know how much contaminant or what the concentration of that contaminant is at the surface. Hopefully this very simple demonstration that we're doing from our kitchen while we're sheltering in place here, hopefully this helps you to visualize what it is that NARAC models with their computer models. Okay, so I've told you a little bit about NARAC, and we've done the demo, and so I thought I'd tell you just a little bit about myself and how I ended up in a STEM field. It definitely wasn't because I was exposed to a lot of science and engineering and technology growing up, but rather I was good at math, I had good grades, I was a good student, but I didn't really know what I wanted to be. And so through encouragement from my high school counselors, you know, being that I was good at math and science, okay, so I would apply for engineering. Once I got to college, luckily I had some really good mentors that helped me to kind of align my interests with my skills and the things I value as a job. So growing up in the Midwest, I loved going outside and observing all the crazy weather, more in the summer than in the winter. And I really wanted to have a job that had a clear mission. So I ended up in atmospheric science. And over time, while I didn't necessarily know what I wanted to be when I grew up, I knew that I was along the right path. So if I had to tell my high school self one thing, it would be, you know, don't focus so much on knowing your exact plan. You don't have to know your exact destination, what you're gonna be, because in all honesty, the way that technology changes these days, the job that you're going to end up in may not even exist today. So if you focus on your path and each step of the way, make sure that you're prioritizing your values, your strengths, and your interests, eventually doors will open and you'll end up in a career that's a good fit for you. Now that I'm in my job, I would say the thing that surprises me the most is how much I love it. I have worked in a lot of different areas and I enjoyed it, but it a lot of times still definitely felt like work. Yes, this is my job and I get paid, but I really, really love my job. I love it because I work with a great team. And not just, of course, my team at Livermore is awesome and we work great together, but we also work with a lot of collaborators around the country throughout the Department of Energy. And it's really awesome to see how all of these different labs come together to make sure that our nation is prepared to respond when needed. So that's the other thing that I really like about my job is that there's a very clear mission. It feels important and valuable to me to be preparing to support our country's safety and international safety as well. There's always something new that I can learn. There are a lot of parts of my job that I didn't know much about when I started, but with doing my PhD, I learned that I'm good at learning. And so I get really excited about digging into those new areas, relying on my teammates that might have expertise that's different than mine so that we can complement each other and bring each other up. So they can learn more about atmospheric science, I can learn more about nuclear physics, and together we really bring our best to the table all the time. Now, of course, things are very different. So I'm working at home still full time, the lab and NARAC remains ready to serve our mission. And when I'm done with work, I'm enjoying time with my kids and we are doing puzzles and playing games. And of course, trying to stay busy, keeping the kids educated, stay fit, go on walks. And so I hope that all of you are also finding ways to make it enjoyable to stay home, stay safe, and stay healthy. All right, thank you.